I thought there was a chance I was going to get through this season without having to do this, but I should have known better. Donskoy with a hat trick tonight. Avs win 9-3 over the Arizona Coyotes.
Oh my goodness gracious! Wasn't it time? Score! Justice is served!
This game was over 7 minutes and 31 seconds into the first period, and nothing really happened for the first 4 minutes of this game. When you count both teams, 6 goals were scored in 3 minutes and 27 seconds. That is the fastest amount of time 6 goals have been scored in my lifetime, and the 5th fastest in the history of the NHL. Language warning, but the Avs straight up made Arizona their bitch in this game. I don't know how else to say it. Let's go. Rapid fire through these 6 goals. Some god-tier forecheck and grind work from this third line, a nice pinch in to keep the play alive from Sam Girard, and all of a sudden Tyson Jost creates a play off of the half wall, gets enough room to fire a shot off, Jonas Donskoy alone in front, Jost creates a rebound, it's a tap-in for Donskoy from there. Literally 20 seconds later, Girard throws a bank pass on the breakout and a nice kind of almost pick play here from Brandon Saad to get this play up the ice to a 2-on-1 situation with Kadri and Berkey. Kadri feeds Berkey for this one, and Berkey does what Berkey does, a 10-10 goal, bar down, baby. Literally 6 seconds later, Arizona tries a stretch pass through the neutral zone. It ends up deflecting off of Cale Makar. Makar misreads the bounce off of himself, gets turned the wrong way, doesn't recognize the puck, leaving room for Bunting to pick it up and cruise past him. That gives enough room for Bunting to walk in, and he puts a beautiful shot top corner over the blocker side of Grubauer. Just in case you thought Arizona was back in this game, the Avs enter in the zone with a nice pass from McDonald up to Compher, who catches Arizona in a bit of a change here, so he has an open lane to the net. It's a bit of a tough angle, though, so he decides to drop it off to Belmar, who unleashes a one-timer, doing his best McKinnon impression from the top of the left circle here, and beats Aiden Hill clean up high. Oh, y'all thought we were done? Less than 30 seconds later, first of all, Donskoy hits a post for post number 45, but Avs somehow maintain possession, work it back up high. Graves throws a shot in. Aiden Hill does not manage the rebound well. Donskoy just continues to be the hottest man on earth. Finds himself skating right towards the puck Hill is knocking away. Oh, that's a wide open net. Guess I'll just throw it in behind his pad. Hill misplays it, and it's in the net. And to top it off, first of all, Aiden Hill has already been pulled. The backup is in for Arizona, and that doesn't change much. Avs get a power play about a minute after their last goal. Landeskog to Rantanen to Donskoy. Some wickedly bad defense from Arizona as nothing gets covered. OEL does not cover the passing lane to Donskoy, and his forward help just disappears into no man's land. Donskoy just gets the load up and score a pretty one to finish off the hat trick. But alright, so I probably broke those down a touch quicker than in real time, but honestly, not by that much. At this point, shots were something like 14-1, the score was 5-1, and despite there being the vast majority of the game left, it was over. The Avs would spend the next 35 minutes in complete cruise control. There's not really a ton to break down here through the rest of the game because it wasn't really competitive hockey at any point. Arizona did hit a post, so that's a 22 count for the good posts. And we'll break down the rest of the goals because that's what I'm here for. It looked for a tiny bit like this could potentially be a game as Arizona cuts the lead to 3 near the end of the first. Arizona on the power play late. The refs gave Arizona 3 consecutive power plays in the second period to manage the game. It is what it is. I said I wouldn't talk about it, so we'll leave it at that. After gaining the zone, they work it down low. Nothing comes of it. A broken play. Ekman-Larsson picks it up at the point. Just throws this shot on net. There's screens in front. It bounces off of something. I'm not entirely sure what, but definitely deflected, and Grubby gets beat. 5-2 after 1. I'm not going to lie to you. The Avs totally half-assed the second period, but why wouldn't you? This game was nearly over, and even half-assing it, at one point they were out shooting Arizona 8-2 in the second period. As is the case with the other teams at the bottom of this division, the Avs are just in a whole different world. Arizona does show up, though. They make you think that maybe the Avs counted the chickens before they hatched, for at least a little bit. near the end of the second period. This is just lazy ugliness. Grubauer throws it around the rim. Girard not working hard to get there results in a turnover initially. It's also not a great pass, but Arizona gains possession. They fumble it. They kind of just throw it around the end boards here, and the Avs eventually do a nice play. Girard, good job to intercept this pass. He kind of tries this weird touch pass to Saad, and Saad tries to skate it directly up the middle. Just lazy. They could have very easily cleared this puck to safety without much trouble at all. Instead, Saad gets poke checked, loses the puck. It comes right back into the Avs zone as everyone is flying the zone, and they pay the price for it as Connor Garland beats Philip Grubauer. So, for 20 whole seconds, everybody thought, maybe this is a game after all. Maybe the Avs actually threw this away a little bit. Haha, no. The Avs immediately flip the switch and get that 3-goal lead right back, essentially crushing Arizona's soul. If you were to look up the phrase, "We're better than you and we know it," this is the play you would find next to that phrase. Trying to clear the puck, Arizona skates it most of the way out of their zone, only to throw an errant backhand pass to no one into the neutral zone, where a waiting Landeskog stick takes it away, walks in, essentially uncontested. All of Arizona just peels away from him as a, you know, as a decent little pick from Rantanen in there, not gonna lie, does get in the way well. Gives Landeskog enough room to load up on a wrister, and Landy just goes, yes, thank you, goodbye. 6-3 after two, and then the third period was just the shooting gallery where the Avs got to kick a team while it was down. Arizona eventually takes another penalty. The Avs laugh and say, don't mind if we do. Pretty standard stuff here. Taze is eventually going to work this puck back over to MacKinnon, and I'm curious. I want to look at the clock here. So MacKinnon receives the puck with 13:59 left on the game clock. He takes his sweet time with this puck. Still holding on to it, still waiting, looking for the right play, looking for it, still holding, staring down Mikko Rantanen across the ice. There, he finally fires it. So maybe not quite a full 3 seconds, but just kind of holding the puck, and Arizona does nothing to pressure him for 3 seconds because they respect his ability that much. The pass gets through anyway, and Mikko easy blast into the net. I feel like I kind of ruined a beautiful play by pausing a bunch there, so here it is again, live at full speed. You can see, MacKinnon gets it, holds, waits, looks, waits, again, waits, and then bam, fakes him out and gets the pass across. What's that, you say? The Avs scored 2 more goals in this game after that one? Yep. Here's the next one. All right, so look, Landeskog 100% chops this stick out of the guy's hands. It's pretty blatant. Probably should have been a penalty, but it goes uncalled, and it creates a 3-on-2 opportunity for the Avs. MacKinnon drops to Rantanen. Landeskog skating towards the near post, connects with Rantanen because the stick is lost, and Landeskog with the finish. 8-3. Tempers start to flare a little bit. Here's everything you need to know about the Nathan MacKinnon helmet incident. Hold that L on the way out. And one more 10-10 snipe of a goal just to finish things off. 1 second left on an Arizona power play. Belmar going to do a great job giving up the body and blocking a shot here. It launches out to the neutral zone where Donskoy wins the foot race as, just off screen, Burakovsky is coming out of the penalty box, and suddenly it's a 2-on-0. Donskoy feeds Burakovsky. Yeah, it's Berkey. It's the Avs anime-powered world, and we are all just living in it. Arizona just happens to be irrelevant bad guy number 37 that they have to mercilessly destroy on their way to the bigger bad guy, the quest for the Stanley Cup. At this moment, the Avs are the best team in the NHL, and that's the end of the chapter. Thank you for watching this game video review. Check out all of our other content. You can check out our backup channel where we're currently putting all of our podcasts because we're working things out with YouTube still. I have no idea when that will be resolved. But yeah, you can also support us on the DNVR.com. I am Rudo, and I am still quite wet.